Let's get visual. Today, I'm going to cover what we think are the top visualization tools in 2023. So I'm pumped. I'll start with the free and more easily accessible ones, and then I'll get into the more pricey and advanced options. Google Sheets. The first one is good old Google Sheets. A lot of marketers are already used to working in Sheets, and Google has been really good at adding, you know, a lot more features to their Google Sheets product. For example, you can now connect data directly from a BigQuery database or from Looker, like actual Looker. See that video to understand the difference between all the Lookers that I made, but yeah, you can now get data from Looker directly into Google Sheets. There's also the option to create your very own custom functions. This is pretty cool, actually. So you're no longer limited to just what Google offers. The visualizations you can create still may not be the most exciting and dynamic ones you've ever seen, but this is a free option and it can kind of get the job done. I personally send data to Google Sheets from Funnel at least once a day. This might be to throw a quick graph together for a colleague, or just to explore some data, or do some digging about some random hypothesis I have. It doesn't mean I use Sheets for my main dashboards, but I do regularly use it for visualization and exploration. I'll actually also show you something that I think is pretty cool built by my colleague Tommy. Now, it's a little hacky, but it is fun. Since we kind of both export map data from Funnel to Sheets a lot, he built this cool add-on that turns your charts from regular Google Sheets colors into your company brand, so that those quick Sheets analysis can be thrown into a deck super quickly without worrying about how bad or generic they might look with the standard Google palette. Let me show you real quick. So you can see here that I'm in Funnel. I've got some just traffic source and clicks. So I'm gonna go ahead and export that to Google Sheets. So I'm already connected, I hit next. I'll just name it something like test for YouTube or whatever. Then I'm gonna export that now. Then I go ahead and open the sheet. So I'll just select these like I normally would and insert a chart. And you can see it's like the regular Google colors, nothing too beautiful or anything. And then I use Tommy's pretty cool tool, a little extension there. I update the charts. And look how pretty. I have this nice, cool, all in the Funnel colors now. Looker Studio. Looker Studio, previously known as Data Studio, remains a great option for marketers to get started with because it's free and, well, pretty easy to use. It's a Google product and Google bought Looker recently, hence the name change that I referred to before. With it being a Google / Looker product, it's really easy for marketers to get data from Google products such as Google Ads and Google Analytics, as well as certain databases like BigQuery, MySQL, and PostgreSQL. You can then also incorporate data from other sources outside of the Google universe, but you need connectors, plugins, or a platform like Funnel to do so. It can be a bit cumbersome with connectors and plugins because you'll need to leverage joins inside Looker Studio to create cross-channel dashboards, but it is really easy to resolve with a partner like Funnel. I know, namaste to a world without blends in Looker Studio. Tableau. Tableau has been around for a while, since 2003 actually, so they know a thing or two about data visualization. Tableau can be used for anything from simple data visualizations to robust dashboards, interactive charts, predictive modeling, and more. You can use the cloud-based version of the software or have it installed locally. Tableau excels in handling and processing large amounts of data quickly. It also offers many different types of graphics and interactive dashboards, so you can really make your data pop and convey your message in the most fun and powerful way. You can actually get pretty artsy with your data visualization in Tableau, so give it a whirl. You can also add data sources relatively easily, but this tool tends to be used with a data warehouse. So it's not the most accessible for all marketers who aren't used to working with moving data around in this way. A data visualization tool like Tableau is probably going to be best suited for larger companies that want to give multiple departments access to company data to create those reports. Or companies with a business intelligence team who can really own and harness the power of all that data. It's also pricey, so your company has to be really willing to make that investment too. Power BI. This one's for all you Microsoft people out there. Power BI is another super powerful data visualization tool that's owned by Microsoft. It's also on the pricey side, and for the more SQL savvy people, when it comes to getting a lot of the data actually into the platform to be able to visualize it. However, there are a lot of data sources that you can connect to Power BI quite easily, like Excel. So, if you're a marketer putting all of your data into Excel, this could be a great option for you to level up your data visualizations. It's also a great solution if your company is running on the Microsoft tech stack, because it's often required to use the software. I mean, with that said, if you don't run on the Microsoft, there are still ways around it. So don't worry if you really want to use Power BI. Power BI is actually another destination that Funnel can send data to. So I'll just show you a real quick demo from one of our customers, build.com, where our friend Cole sends data into Power BI to work with and create a dashboard.
We're in the Funnel UI, and we can see that some different data sources are already connected here across AdWords, Facebook, some Google Analytics, and even some Twitter data in there. What's in here? We've got by date. It's going to split by traffic source, the campaign, the media type. And then we've got some common metrics: cost, impression, clicks, CPM, CPC, and CTR. It's straightforward to add in other metrics if we needed to, but I think that's sufficient for this report. This is what our data set will look like. What I would do next is I would save this. What we want to do is we want to create a new data set to pipe into Power BI. So we click New Data Share. Next step would be to jump over to Power BI. So we've got a blank Power BI template here. We'll just go get data, more. Here is Funnel. And with our account, we have several different connections. But the one that we're going to work off of is this Power BI demo data. And there is the Funnel to Power BI test data set that we just created in the UI. I've been impressed at how snappy, we can make a change in Funnel. Let's say we add a column, and I can come into Power BI and refresh it, and it shows up right away. I don't have to wait 30 minutes or anything like that. It's pretty responsive. So now here's our data set in the Power Query Editor. We can kind of look it over, make changes if we need to. This top view is where we can build our report. So there's a quick dashboard with Funnel data in Power BI.
We also did a collaboration with Ruth over at Kerbal, who I would argue is the Power BI expert and has over 100,000 subscribers on YouTube. So check out the video we did with her or her channel in general if you want to learn how to use Power BI. I promise you, if you have had a question, she's answered it with a video. Well, those are the top visualization tools for 2023, according to Funnel. And surprise, surprise, we can send clean data to all of these to help make it smoother for you to visualize your data. That's it for today. If you found this video useful, like and subscribe, where you'll get more videos about digital marketing, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.